What's up, YouTube? I'm Casey with bestinvestingapps.com, and today we're talking about StockTwits, a social sharing Twitter meets investing app that's out. It's been out for a while, and we're going to talk about what I like about it, what I don't like about it, things that you should be using it for, or maybe some things you should watch out for. And if you stick around, I'm going to be giving away a few free copies of my ebook, Invest. So make sure you watch out for that. So what is StockTwits? StockTwits is effectively Twitter smashed into investing. As you go to the homepage, you make an account, you can see there's a live stream of updated information from other investors. You can tag certain stocks or certain indexes. You can follow other investors. You might find popular people from the Wall Street Journal, columnists, authors. You might even find some hedge fund traders. Anybody can have a StockTwits profile. You can share your ideas, you can learn other people's ideas, get a better sense of what's going on. The whole concept is that social investing helps improve everyone's knowledge, and we can kind of scroll through and see what other people are talking about. And hopefully, if it helps you out, it'll give you a better idea of what people are talking about, where the market's moving, help stimulate some thoughts for you, and maybe you can find some other investors that you really enjoy following. You'll find my link down below. I only use StockTwits on occasion, but feel free to follow me and we can share ideas. One cool feature about StockTwits is that as you're scrolling around or if you have an idea, you can come in and you can type in a ticker symbol or you can click on someone's ticker symbol. Wow, this is going crazy right now. I don't know why it's updating so fast at the moment. So let's say I want to find out more about Apple. I type in the ticker symbol. I hit enter. I can find any information that anyone has posted about Apple recently, with the most recent on top. And I can see a little price chart. I can check out message volume. So this shows me how much people are talking about a certain stock or a certain ETF. I can also see sentiment. This sentiment rating is totally based on StockTwits users. So when you type in a comment about Apple, you have to tell StockTwits whether you're bullish or bearish, and then StockTwits collects all the data and shows it as a little graph here. It's kind of neat. Gives you some cool social insight onto what other investors are feeling about a certain security. And we'll talk a little more about the dangers of social investing, but I think it's pretty neat, and it gives you some quick tools to make some good decisions about what's happening, how hot something is, and how traded it is. If you saw my TradingView review just the other day, then you already know how powerful a charting tool TradingView is. A lot of users of StockTwits tend to post with TradingView. The two apps go hand in hand. They're very good together. Check the show notes below for a link to my TradingView review if you don't know what that is. For many of you who might be penny stock traders and who may be using the Robinhood app and the TradingView app, all of those are apps that I have reviewed that I use. StockTwits could be a really good place for you to check out. If you are trading a stock that's down in the $2, $1, $5 range, sentiment and social sharing could be really important to you because you may find that a stock with that small of a value can really get pushed around even by small investors. So if I can get a sense of what other people are saying and doing here, that might actually help me out with my trade. I could predict and or participate in momentum and directional trades using StockTwits as just one of many tools to get a sense of where that penny stock is heading. One of the coolest and one of my favorite aspects about StockTwits is the heat map. So up here at the top, I can click on heat map. Brings up this cool heat map of different sectors. And the red and green represent sentiment, so longs and shorts, based on StockTwits conversations. So if I click on healthcare, I see this big red one down here. What are people so negative about right now? I see it's DCTH. I have no idea what that is. So I'm gonna click on it. Let's find out what DCTH is. Delcath Systems Inc. People really think that it's heading down. Surprisingly, the sentiment is pretty positive. I don't know what's going on here. This might be something to look into more deeply. So I can get a sense of big movers here. Maybe I find something that looks positive. AVEO looks like it's got a positive sentiment. Maybe I look into it a little deeper. This is just one tool that I can use to help navigate around, quickly see what's good, what's bad, as far as what other people are talking about. We can also come and check on the other side here with stocks. I can look at stocks by industry, individual stocks that are rising or falling. Pretty neat, pretty handy. Not something that is really unique. A lot of other platforms offer that, but the heat map may be a little unique. The one thing that I warn you about is this heat map is based solely off of StockTwits users and therefore is not representative of the sentiment of the entire market. StockTwits users are only a small portion of the market. And while StockTwits users might be positive or negative about an investment, the rest of the market may do something completely different. So don't base your trades solely off of what Joe Schmo says on StockTwits. That brings me right into my final point and my warning to you about social sharing investing services. I want to remind everyone that just because someone on StockTwits says something does not mean that it's going to happen. In fact, it doesn't even mean that it's true. We all know and hate the little corner of the internet world that looks something like this. The internet is full of trolls. People could be right, they could be wrong, they could be malicious, they could be trolling you. You never know what people are on about. You don't know if their motives are positive or negative. They could be long on something and they could come on StockTwits and start telling people to short it to try to get the stock to turn around and make money out of it. Who knows? You don't know what's going on. You need to make sure you do your own research. Be really careful about blindly following people on StockTwits. You have no idea whether they're educated, completely randomly guessing, or misleading you, maybe even on purpose. So watch out for that, but feel free to use StockTwits. Come join me, follow me, get ideas from other people. It is a good service overall, and I like it. Just make sure you take everything with about 20 grains of salt when it comes to social sharing and investments. The last thing that I want to mention is that StockTwits is a free platform. They make their money by advertising, so let me show you what I mean. And this gets pretty ugly. I'm going to turn off my ad block, so pause ad blocker, refresh the page, and see what it looks like with its normal view. Here we go. We've got advertisement, advertisement, advertisement up here. And if I remember right, there are even some like midstream advertisements that happen. But anyways, there's the advertisement version. Here is the ad blocked version, just so you can see a comparison. I recommend that you use ad blocker with it. The service is nice and clean. It looks better. It performs better. It's less distracting. So just a tip for you as you get started with StockTwits. I know I promised to give away some free copies of my ebook, so check the description below, find the link to Invest, my free ebook, go download that. It'll get you started investing in just 3 easy steps. It's aimed at the beginner investor, so if you're already established or you know what you're doing, might not be the best book for you. For those of you who are a little hesitant or haven't started yet, perfect book for you, so go check it out. I hope you enjoyed this review. Leave me a comment, give us a thumbs up if we helped you make money, save money, or avoid making a mistake. And we'll see you next time.